A good video game level should feel like a dialogue with the level designer. It needs an opponent, and I don't mean enemy AIs or a boss fight. I mean a rival equal to the player, someone you can outsmart but can also outsmart you. Most games have levels designed to let you play with yourself, and that's fine, Far Cry has kept me entertained for hours, but it's also clear that there's no one on the other side of the glass. If you poke, it shatters and the illusion is ruined. It's why I love Arkane. Every single one of their games feels like a one-on-one. Take Prey for example. Prey involves a mechanic that lets you craft almost anything, including neuromods, the game's equivalent of skill points. Most players will craft a few over the course of their playthrough, but what if you're resourceful? What if you try to outsmart the game, and convert everything that is nailed down into ingredients for your neuromod factory? DRM, seriously. There is copy protection on neuromods, and you just got banned. This sets off a whole side quest to re-enable your crafting privileges. You play the smart move and the level designer played the smarter one. This philosophy of a tete-a-tete culminates in the Clockwork Mansion in Dishonored 2. Home of Kirin Jindosh, a genius inventor you're tasked with assassinating. It is a spectacular piece of architecture. The walls constantly shift, the rooms change form and function, and Jindosh takes pride in showing it all off to you. So does Dana Nightingale, the level designer Arkane who conceptualized the mansion. She has been killing it for years, and if you're an immersive sim fan, you've played her work. From Deathloop to Dishonored to some of the best mods for Thief 2. The Clockwork Mansion, to me, is her finest work, because the glass between player and level designer has never been thinner. We enter into a modest room that, with a pull of a lever, transforms into a lavish lobby guarded by its intricate machines. Ever the showman, Jindosh welcomes us into his home before trapping us in a room with his robotic guards. His house is a death trap, and every room has something new. From the machines and squads of guards, to arc pylons and walls of light that can fry us to a crisp. Jindosh delights in tracking our movement too, and he keeps taunting us over the PA system.
You're quite close now. I can't remember any other visitor getting so far. Do you feel pride?
He has a staggering amount of lines for anything you may do. So not only does the level react, but it speaks to us too, with the confidence of a genius watching a rat trapped in a maze. We take the elevator up, a little battered, and arrive in Jindosh's laboratory. He's prepared, and it's a tough fight, but it is possible to kill him like this. Possible, but not satisfying, because Dana outsmarted you every step of the way. Let's reset the board. Jindosh played a strong opening. It's designed to show off his genius, but that pride also means it's so much easier to know where to slip the knife in. The same goes for the mansion itself. The mechanics move slowly, with grandeur, giving us a moment to slip in between. What happens if we get into the walls? We'll be crushed, yes, sometimes. But sometimes not. The space between. Servants' quarters, walkways for maintaining the house, hidden from guests. Peppered with signs reminding the cleaners not to step too loudly or whistle. There's even an entire kitchen and a waterfall that serves as the powerhouse of this contraption. Getting behind the walls is our gambit, but Jindosh reacts.
It seems like a reasonable guess that somehow you've gotten beyond the inner walls of the house.
We're in the goddamn walls. He's twitchy, and his soldiers are alert, dreading the ding of that elevator. He won't hear it. Let's stop a floor short, just under his laboratory.
Welcome to the final mystery, Jindosh.
But Jindosh and Dana were still one step ahead. They say the only winning move is not to play, so why don't we step away from the board for a minute? There's an unanswered question here. You may have thought of it already. How can Jindosh even track us? The answer? Pressured floors in all of his rooms. It's how he knows we've arrived from the moment we step foot in here. So let's play again. Let's avoid the floor, jumping from counter to cabinet, and slip into the servant's quarters before he even notices. Do not set any mechanism off. Move quietly, teeter across the balustrade, and climb up the elevator shaft.